Good morning. I'm just gonna take a moment to kind of land and take a few deep breaths. As you're joining in, please do the same. We're just gonna find a comfortable spot on the floor. If you have a mat, that's great. If you don't, it's fine. You should be able to do this yoga class without a mat. But if you do have a mat, that will be great. This is intended to be a flow class. So we'll be doing standing poses, we'll be moving, we'll be getting the energy flowing. So just please find your comfortable seat and just start to drop in here. This class is about an hour long. However, I usually start just around 9, sometimes a couple minutes late, like today. And I'll take the first 10 minutes or so to just check in. This is an opportunity for more people who are planning on being on the class to jump on. It's an opportunity for you to grab whatever you need to get ready. And it's an opportunity for me to share a little bit more about myself. So one of the things that I've enjoyed over the past 10 years of teaching yoga is really getting to know my students and allowing you all to get to know who I am. One of the things that's really interesting about being a yoga teacher is there's a certain kind of light that yoga teachers are often painted in, or they paint themselves in. And I've noticed even my own tendency to want to show up in a certain way every single time, to be really put together, to be really grounded, to be really centered. And while that's a beautiful intention, it isn't really always possible. And so today I was kind of feeling a little bit frazzled, and I slept as late as I could because I was up quite late last night, and I wanted to get as much sleep as possible, which meant I didn't have as much time to get ready this morning. And it's interesting, even with a commute that only goes from the bedroom to the living room, I can still feel like I'm running late. I can still feel kind of that rushed sensation. And so it's a testament to the fact that it really isn't circumstantial, but it's something that's within us. And so I will often resist the urge to show up in a certain way and really just show up as I am, because I'm a human just like all of you out there, and we have good days and we have bad days. You know, there's days where I wake up with plenty of time to do my meditation and put on a little bit of makeup and feel really good, and there's days that I slept in my clothes from yesterday. Didn't have time to put on any makeup, and tired and gonna show up that way as well. So I usually pick a different theme for each of my yoga classes, and the theme that I'm working with today is the theme of self-care. And sometimes we teach about the things that we need the most. I was building a fort in the woods yesterday, and it was labor-intensive work, and it was a really long experience, and we had a beautiful fire pit under the stars with this fort the next day, or I mean yesterday. And at the end of the fort building experience, a number of the people that were there, because some of you might know this, if you don't, I've been quarantined in a group, which I think a lot of people are at this point, and if you aren't, people are starting to get quarantined into a group. So a couple of people from the group requested a little bit of body work. And there's an experience that my friends and I will do where we'll have one person receive and, you know, maybe four or five people giving in this body work circle. And which works great if you've been quarantined together for a month, right? Or whenever we get all unquarantined. And so these are the couple of people that were able to receive last night. I've really been working hard. They've been working hard all week. They're working really hard on the build. And so it was a really beautiful experience to be able to give that body work to them. And especially in a group situation. We even had one person that was just kind of witnessing and like, just wow. And so we stayed up late giving to the people that we could, and there wasn't enough time to get to everybody, and it was starting to get really late, and I came to the room and was getting ready for my sleep, my very short sleep, and I realized that I was having a lot of pain in my body as well, in my back, in my psoas, in my neck. And I came to this kind of crossroads of like, what does self-care mean to me in that moment? And it could have gone a couple of different ways, and it's going to be different each time. But I had this choice where, yes, I knew I needed to sleep because I was getting up, quote-unquote, early to teach this yoga class. But I also really needed to get my muscles to release. And I've been working really hard on breaking codependent patterns in my life. One of the loves in my life is a body worker, so I'm able to receive body work quite often. But I was noticing this like codependency on this other person to receive body work if I was feeling something in my body. So I've been really taking care to learn how to care for myself in a very physical way, in a way that oftentimes we will defer to someone else to quote-unquote help us. And I think help is one of the biggest codependent words that we use in English. You know, it's one thing to ask for support, something that you can already do, but it's another thing to ask for help. That's implying that it's something that you can't do for yourself. So last night I took the time to just give myself some self-massage. And I have a couple of different tools that I use to do that. I'm going to save that for another video to show the tools that I use for that specific type of self-massage. But I was just really happy for myself, really proud of myself. You know, I woke up this morning with not very much pain in my body at all after spending all day lifting logs and building things and massaging people and all of this. And it really felt... There's a quote that I love that says, sometimes people give up what they really want for what they want right now. And I could have easily done that last night. I could have easily given up what I really wanted, which is to feel really good in my body over the long term, for what I wanted right then, which was to go to sleep. And it really only took 10 minutes. So with that said, we're going to carry that theme forward into this yoga class. We're going to do just some light movement, a little bit of self-massage to get us started. I'll sometimes reserve this practice for my restorative yoga classes, which I teach on Tuesdays and Thursdays at 3 p.m. Mountain Time, also on Facebook Live. But today I've decided to take some of that self-care practice, that self-massage from my restorative class, and bring it in here into the beginning of our flow class. So for those of you that are just joining, please feel free to join in for this kind of meditation and drop in the beginning, a little bit of the self-massage. If you're able to stay for the flow, I would absolutely love to have you. And if you're unable to stay, you know, this class will be on a replay. So I post it on my Facebook page as a replay, and I also post it on my YouTube channel. So let's go ahead and get started. I also just want to make a little shout out. I'll probably make more of an intentional post about this later in the day, but just a shout out to the world and especially to my Denver family. Happy 420. You know, I have been throwing these Howl at the Moon gatherings. And last year on 420 was a really big community gathering that we had in Morrison, Colorado. And I think it was like 300 people that came together. It was completely community run beautiful event with music and massage and workshops, and we were intending to do it again this year, but with the COVID thing we were unable to. So just kind of holding space in my heart for that event and for that community, and may we be able to gather and actually massage each other and receive from each other soon, because I miss you guys. Alright, so let's find our comfortable seat. Sit up nice and tall. Close the eyes. And just begin to breathe. In through the nose. And out through the mouth. Let's take a couple more like that. This is a cleansing breath. A breath of letting go. Take a moment to just consciously choose what you are letting go of right now. Two more deep breaths. Last one. As you allow your breath to return to normal, I invite you at this time to set an intention for your day, your week, your practice. Maybe you have an intention you've been working with for the year, or kind of a series of intentions that are unfolding for you. Maybe your intention is around this practice of self-care, of taking care of your own needs. Once you've set your intention, please bring the palms to press together at heart center. We'll begin our practice with two cleansing breaths and one om. And this om, as you sound it in your own personal space, is intended to fill the space, to cleanse the space, to set this sacred space for yourself today, for your own self-care. Two cleansing breaths and one om in through the nose, and out through the mouth. This time, sigh. With the eyes closed, rub the hands together, create a little bit of heat and friction with the hands. And place the hands over the eyes. Let the heat of the hands soften the face and smile. And gently flutter the eyes open and float the hands down. Let's start with the legs fully extended. Finding yourself sitting on your haunches here, nice and tall. We're just going to do a quick few forward fold flows. So inhale, reach it up, touch the palms overhead. And exhale, just an easy fold. You might notice, don't come down as far as you usually do first thing in the morning. Let's do a couple more just like that. Big inhale, full rotation of the shoulders. And exhale. Let's do two more. Last one, big inhale. And exhale. And slowly come on up. Widening the feet just a little bit. You're going to make little fists out of the hands. And start to, you can even bend one knee. I'm not feeling quite as limber in this moment, so you don't have to try too hard here. And the stretching will get there. And just give yourself some love through the calf. This is a great way to activate your chi, your body's energy, especially after waking up in the morning, or if you find yourself taking this class after sitting at a desk on a computer, driving a car for a long period of time. And working your way up into the thighs. I did this maybe about a month ago, so let me know if you've done it with me before, or if you've done it on your own, how it feels for you. You can work your hands up into the hip area. Around the lower belly. Back down the leg. To the other side. Making some fists here, waking up the calves. For those of you just jumping on, just doing a little bit of self-care here today, working into a yoga flow, you're welcome to join in for all or part as you wish. So using the hands to wake up the calf. Up into the upper leg. Get the hamstring from this position. Quadricep, the hip area. From here, with your hands, you'll work into the lower back, the glutes, and then how flexible your shoulders are, but just see what you can do. And continue breathing deeply. And around, this is where I'll cup the hands and working into the lung area. This is great if you do have any kind of respiratory situation. This can help clear any stagnation, any phlegm in the lungs, in the chest. I usually go back to fists when I'm in the chest area. This can help clear stagnation in the lungs. Also, with the emotions. These are the grief points, that kind of Tarzan. It's a great way to release grief, whether it's grief about the life that for all of us is changing so much, or someone or something that you've lost in your life. Any kind of grief. You might feel tender here. And then cupping the hand once again, working on the arm. You can make a fist in these kind of bigger muscles at the top of the arm. And cupping the hand into the bottom of the arm. Just play around with the cupped hand versus the fist. Kind of like the fist in this part of the forearm. And just You can massage the meaty part of the thumb. Massaging into the hand chakra in the center of the hand. This is really good to do before you give body work or energy work to someone else to open up that channel. Let's do just a little stretch here with the wrists. We can come back to that one in a different way. So, palms to the heart center, forearms parallel to the ground, and press your elbows over to the right, and then press your fingertips over to the right, keeping that right shoulder dropped. You're going to feel a nice forearm stretch and hand stretch here, a couple deep breaths. That cleansing breath, that open mouth exhale can release physical tension as you feel a stretch. Or mental or emotional tension as well. Let's do one more big inhale. And coming back through center, pressing hands to the other side. So forearms parallel to the ground, shoulders down. And press the fingertips to the left. You can see that left hand kind of bends backwards a little bit here. Couple of deep breaths. Two more. Last one. You can kind of do the same thing on this other arm so you can see how it feels to stretch more. Specifically in this way, massage into the hand chakra, opening up that hand channel, massaging into the meaty part of the thumb, and then starting to get back into that tapping through the forearm. Using a fist or a hand, opening up the body's energy channel, activating your chi, getting ready for the practice and the day, and you can work into the upper part of the arm and the shoulder. Once you get up to the neck area, I'm going to start to really intentionally massage here. So with like a squeezing motion of the hands, I really love doing this for myself because, you know, it feels so good when someone comes up behind you and gives you a squeeze on the shoulders. You don't have to wait for someone else to do that, to have that experience, especially if you're working on a computer, or you can play around with what feels best, how you utilize your arms and your hands. If you do have trigger points in the body, you can use your fingers to pull and pin them, and then move the neck and the shoulders to get them to release. I like to really squeeze my neck here with one hand. And then the other. So you can kind of move and sway. Take the hands and bring the thumbs along the occipital ridge, the base of the skull. One of the teachings that I've learned, they call that occipital ridge the pain ridge. So whenever I'm working that area on myself or on a client in a healing session, I always say the words in my head, release, 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 just to release any pain. Keep breathing deep here as you begin to work your hands along the front line of the neck, the scalenes. So these muscles in the front of the neck, you can kind of squeeze and pull just a little bit. Be gentle here. And you like to only do one side at a time. It's just kind of hard to pull on both. Just grab and give a squeeze and a breathe. Down the front of the neck. You can work the fingers down towards the collarbone, walking up the front of the collarbone, these tender points here. And just start to massage the neck and into the jaw, where the jaw meets the ear. Right here can be quite tender. We hold a lot of tension in our jaw, so just give yourself a moment to explore this, especially if you're someone who loves to receive body work but hasn't been able to because of the quarantine. Give yourself a moment to breathe and savor it, just like if a massage therapist were working on you, you know, you'd be like, ah, make a sound. Sounding is so important. And working the fingers up into the jaw area here, massaging the mandibles. You might notice one side's tighter than the other. You can just make a mental note and give a little bit of extra care to that side as you move throughout your week. If you find a little trigger point, you can do a technique called twina, where you press into the trigger point and move quickly side to side and help dissolve it, visualizing dissolving it as you're working it. And up into the face. This is the fun part of being on video, and you can really let your face look weird. And up into the temples. Massage into your temples. And I really love this area back behind the temples. I hold a lot of tension there. So you can spend some time massaging the side of the head. Giving your ears a squeeze. Pull the ears up and back and down. And massaging the scalp. Just like you're shampooing your head. This is always my favorite part of getting my hair done or getting a massage. And just know, you can give yourself the same care that you require of other people. I often find it to be even more powerful. Focusing on that crown area, that center line. And into the forehead. You can rub. I really like tapping on the face. Just lightly tapping with the fingertips around the forehead. And the cheeks, up the bridge of the nose, into the jaw once again. I kind of miss this one, this sliding the thumbs up and underneath the jaw to release those tendons under there. And you can slide the thumbs, actually I guess from this angle the fingers work a little bit better, but there's some tendons where the upper jaw meets the lower jaw, or I guess cheeks meet the upper jaw. So just massage into those tendons. If you find that trigger point, you can kind of wiggle it out and get back to that tapping. Maybe slapping a little bit. My roommate in yoga teacher training in Nepal, shout out to Yuka if you're out there. She told me that in her culture, she's from Japan, that every morning you're supposed to slap your face for as many years as you have. counted that one. My birthday's in a couple of weeks. I did the year that I will be. And then last but not least, I always do this one last because I want to do it after I massage my face. We're going to get into the feet just a little bit. So just crossing one foot over the other leg and give yourself a moment to kind of tug on your toes. If you can crack your toes, great. My toes don't crack. When I studied Thai massage in Thailand, they really want you to crack the toes, and for whatever reason, mine just won't. And massaging in the sole of the foot, I like to kind of dig my thumbs in to the ball of the foot. Move all that flesh back to its proper protective place, and squeezing along the outer edge of the foot here. Massaging that inner edge, that arch area. A lot of people really feel it in that area. Squeezing the heel. If you have any plantar fasciitis, you can use a knuckle in the center of the heel. And actually probably a couple knuckles to keep it strong. You can really massage that connection point with the where the plantar fascia connects. And I like to go back to the slapping and the tapping. And switching to the other foot. Give some tugs on the toes. This is really good if you're somewhere where it's cold, and it's kind of cold where I am. So getting some blood into the toes before we start our yoga practice. Such an important part of our balancing and grounding. You can really crack the toes if you feel like it. If you did it on the other side. And massaging the ball of the foot. Especially if you wear high heels, which right now we're all stuck inside. I don't know who is wearing high heels right now, but if you are, this is an important part. Squeezing along that outer edge of the foot. Massaging the inner arch. Ooh, if you have a trigger point, working that tweena technique. You can use the knuckles again to get into that heel area. And squeezing the heel. And slapping or tapping along the feet. For those of you that stuck with me through that whole series of self-massage, I'd love to know how you're feeling. And let's find our way into the tabletop position. Hands under the shoulders, knees under the hips. And on an inhale, lift the tailbone, lift the gaze. And on an exhale, round it up, tuck the chin, press the earth away. And just start to feel sensation into the spine. Allow this movement with your breath to be what is massaging the spine right now. And you allow the breath to massage the spine. Three more deep breaths here. Two. Last one, big inhale. And exhale. Inhale through tabletop, pause here. Moving into a shoulder opener here, inhale, left arm reaches. And exhale, thread it through underneath the right arm, left shoulder to the earth, left ear to the earth. Draw the hips back to square and tiptoe that right hand forward. Press the right armpit towards the left elbow, a couple of deep breaths here. Ah. Two more deep breaths. Last one, big inhale. And slowly tiptoe that right hand back, planting by the face. Inhale, left arm lifts up. And exhale, back to center. Second side, inhale, right arm reaches. Exhale, thread it underneath. Right shoulder to the earth, right ear to the earth. Tiptoe the left hand forward. And press the left armpit towards the right elbow. Square the hips. Three deep breaths. Two. Last one. Big inhale. And exhale. Tiptoe the left hand back, plant it by the face. Inhale, right arm reaches. And exhale, come on back. Walk the hands forward from tabletop position about 1.5 hand lengths. We're going to circle the hips. So inhale, hips towards the heels. And then on your next inhale, swing the hips right and forward. And exhale, left and back. Two more deep breaths. Last one, big inhale. And exhale. And opposite direction, inhale, swing the hips left and forward. Your knees might crack, that's okay, as long as they don't hurt. Two more. Last one. Let's find our way to downward facing dog. So tuck the toes, lift the hips, downward facing dog. And then just take a moment to pedal out the feet. Then one knee at a time as you press one heel at a time towards the earth. Wake up the calves, the feet, the hips. Wake up from the hands, through the arms, the shoulders. Three, two more deep breaths. Last one, big inhale. And exhale. And slowly walk forward for ragdoll. Bend the knees a lot. Grab opposite elbows. Let the head hang. Slowly sway side to side as once again you bend and straighten the legs in opposition to each other. Just imagine any stress or drama or tension just rolling off the back. Releasing out of the crown of the head. You might balance here or circle the head or open and close the jaw a couple of times. One more big inhale. And exhale. Release the arms, squeeze the inner thighs, come on up to a halfway lift. And exhale, dive deep. Two more just like that. Big inhale. And exhale. Last one, inhale up halfway. And exhale, dive deep. Inhale, reverse a swan dive all the way up to standing. And exhale. Bring the hands to the heart. Come back to your intention. Take a moment to really check in with yourself. Check in with your intention. Deep breath. On your next inhale, sweep the arms up, touch the arms overhead. Exhale, tip to the right. Inhale up through center. And exhale, tip to the left. We'll do one more on each side. Inhale. And exhale over. Inhale. And exhale over. Beautiful. Inhale up through center. Exhale, swan dive down. Inhale up to a halfway lift. Exhale, plant the hands, step back, high plank position. So we had a nice, easy introduction to the class today, but this class is intended to be a flow class. It's intended to get the heart beating. It's intended to get the body weight up. It's intended to activate the core so that you can be more intentional with everything you do throughout your day. So taking a few deep breaths here to tap into your core. If you'd like, you can tap your knee to your elbow on opposing sides, doing 4, 6, 8, or 10, whatever feels good to you. Even numbers here, activating that core. You can always just hold in that high plank position, or you can hold with the knees to the earth. I did this for a number of years when I was first beginning. And we're going to find our way to the floor, taking a nice big inhale here. I'll demo it on the knees. And exhale, slowly lower all the way to the earth. Release the feet to the top of the earth. And slowly inhale up through low cobra. And exhale, roll it down. We'll do this a few times. Inhale up. So you can start to find your medium cobra and work your way into your high cobra here. Exhale, lower. Three more. Two. Last one. So inhale up through tabletop. And exhale, child's pose. So gently sitting on the knees and releasing the forehead to the earth. I really like to take child's pose up on itsy bitsy spider fingers, as I like to call them. Elbows lifted, wrists lifted as well. Forehead to the earth. Take a moment to breathe into that back body, the kidneys, the adrenals. Two more deep breaths. Last one. Release the hands. Inhale up through tabletop. Exhale, tuck the toes and lift the hips for downward facing dog. Inhale, right leg lifts. Open up the hip, bend into the knee. Drop the left heel. You can look under the left armpit to level the shoulders. Roll out the right ankle. And roll out the right hip. Ooh. Inhale, right leg reaches up towards the sky. Exhale, knee to the nose. Inhale, reach it up and back. And exhale, knee to the left elbow. Inhale, reach it up and back. Exhale, knee to the right elbow or the right armpit if you can keep it high. Inhale, reach it up and back. And exhale, step it through. Staying high in your lunge here today. A high lunge, because that back knee is lifted off the ground. If you'd like to place the back knee down, please feel free to do so. Just rocking forward and back. Finding a little bounce, a little bit of levity here. come on up for crescent and breathe. Get strong and long in your stance here. Some of you might remember from the other day, I like to bend my back knee a little bit just to angle my pelvis in line with my torso. See how that feels in your body. Couple of deep breaths here. Two more. Last one, big inhale. And exhale. Notice I kind of pulse with my breath. See how that feels. Inhale here. Exhale, rotate the back heel down. Blossom open into your warrior two. Shoulders are level in the same plane. Gaze over that right middle finger. Really root down into that right heel. Right heel aligns with the inner arch of the left foot. Two more deep breaths here. Last one, big inhale. And on your exhale, right forearm to right knee, left arm up and over for extended side angle. Keep that right knee over the right ankle. And make sure you're not sinking down into that right shoulder. So there's pressure to lift up and out as you rotate the heart towards the sky. Finding a beautiful straight line from the outside of that left foot out through the left fingertips. Two more deep breaths. Last one, big inhale. And exhale. Inhale, up and back, straighten the right leg, reach the right arm up for reverse triangle. And on an exhale, tip at the hips and bring the hands down. Right hand can come to the right shin, or it can come to the earth in front of or behind that right foot. If you're used to using a yoga block and you don't have one, you can use a water bottle or a pot from the kitchen. So working that right leg towards straight, again stacking the shoulders. And that right arm traditionally goes up. I personally really like it forward, so just see how that feels in your body. You can play around with that. Two more deep breaths. If you want an extra challenge, you can bring the bottom arm up. This is going to work those abs. One more big inhale. And exhale. Inhale, up and back, bend into the right knee for a reverse warrior. And on an exhale, windmill down, right hand, left hand, step it back through high plank. Now you have an option to flow through your traditional vinyasa, which I'll demo in a minute, or you'll come all the way to the earth. Inhale up through cobra, exhale lower, inhale through tabletop or high plank, and exhale downward facing dog. If you'd like to move through a vinyasa, it looks a little bit different. So from high plank, I always say inhale, stay high or come to the knees. I like to roll forward on my toes just a little bit, so that when I come halfway, my elbows stay over the wrists in chaturanga. Flip to the tops of the feet and the hands, only things touching for up dog, and rolling up and over the toes for a downward facing dog. And we'll always meet in downward facing dog. So if you want to skip your vinyasa, feel free to do that. Okay, second side, inhale, left leg lifts. Stack the hips, bend into that left knee. Drop into the right heel. And gaze under the right armpit. Roll out the left ankle. Roll out the left hip. Both directions, keep breathing. Inhale, left leg lifts straight up and back. Exhale, knee to the nose. Inhale, reach it up and back. And exhale, knee to the right elbow. Inhale, reach it up and back. Exhale, to the left elbow or armpit. Inhale, reach it up and back. And exhale, step it through. So take a moment to land here. Find a little rock. Find a little bounce. We're moving through a little bit more of this standing series than we have done in the past couple of weeks. So take a moment to really ground into your foundation of your feet. Once you feel really strong in your foundation, then come on up through crescent pose and breathe. Again, you can bend that back knee to integrate the pelvis. 3 deep breaths here. Stay deep, left knee over left ankle. 2 more. Last one, big inhale. And exhale. Inhale here. Exhale, blossom open. Warrior 2. Left heel aligned with the inner arch of that right foot. Shoulders in the same plane in both directions. Knee over ankle. Gazing forward for 3. Last one, big inhale. And on your exhale, left forearm to left knee, right arm up and over. Finding that straight line once again from the outer edge of that back foot out through the fingertips. And coming up and out of the shoulder, rotate the heart towards the sky. For 3, 2, and 1. Big inhale. And exhale. Straightening that left leg. Reach the left arm up and back. This is reverse triangle, reverse trikonasana. And then windmill down for triangle pose. So hand can be on the shin or on the earth or with the water bottle. That's a part of my self-care today, to not go as deep into this position. And reaching that right arm straight up towards the sky, or maybe over in front of you. Breathe. 3 deep breaths. There's always a micro bend in that standing knee, so you don't hyperextend it. We're rotating the heart open, keeping both side bodies nice and long. And maybe reaching the arms straight up and out. One more big inhale. And exhale. Inhale up, bend into that left knee. Reach it back, reverse warrior. And exhale, windmill down. Left hand, right hand. You can always come right to downward facing dog or lower all the way to the earth. Or you're going to find your way through your vinyasa, through up dog, through down dog. And once again, please find child's pose. Drop to the knees, sit it back, release the forehead to the earth. 3 deep breaths here for 3, 2, last one, big inhale. And exhale. Inhale up through tabletop position. And exhale, downward facing dog. Inhale, bend the knees and look at the hands. And exhale, step or hop to the top of the mat. Inhale up to a halfway lift. Exhale, dive deep forward fold. Notice the bent knees. Give it a try. Inhale, reverse your swan dive all the way up. And exhale, hands to the heart. Come back to your intention. Inhale, reach it up. We're going to flow this time. Exhale, tip to the right. Inhale, reach it up. And exhale, tip to the left. Inhale, reach up. Exhale, swan dive down. Inhale to a halfway lift. Exhale, plant the hands, step or hop back, flow through vinyasa and or meet in downward facing dog. Inhale, right leg lifts, open it up. And exhale, knee to the nose. Inhale, reach it up and back. You can open it up if you choose. And exhale to the left elbow. Inhale up and back. Maybe you open it up. And exhale to the right side. Inhale up and back. And exhale, step it through. Inhale up through crescent. Exhale, blossom, open warrior two. Inhale, extended side angle. Exhale, reverse triangle. Inhale, start to tip forward. And exhale, triangle pose, trikonasana, hold for a full breath cycle. Inhale, up and back through reverse warrior, bend into that front knee. And exhale, windmill down. Find your way to downward facing dog. You can take your vinyasa ekapada, 1 foot lifted, if you choose. And meeting through downward facing dog. Take a sigh with me here, big inhale. And exhale. Inhale, left leg lifts. Oh, let's do it up, yeah, let's do it. And exhale, knee to the nose. Inhale, up and back, open that hip if you'd like. And exhale, knee to the right elbow. Inhale, up and back. And exhale, knee to the left. Inhale, up and back. And exhale, step it through. Inhale, up through crescent. And exhale. Blossom open warrior two. Inhale, extended side angle. Exhale, reverse triangle. Inhale, start to tip. And exhale, trikonasana, triangle pose, hold for a breath cycle. Inhale, up through reverse warrior. Bend in that front knee. And exhale, windmill down, step it back, flow through your vinyasa. And we will meet through downward facing dog, once again into child's pose. Three deep breaths here. Two. Last one, big inhale, and exhale, and slowly start to find your way back up through tabletop, into downward facing dog. When you're ready, you're going to step or hop through to seated. In the seated position, bring the soles of the feet together, knees wide. Draw the feet as close to your body as you can. Grab a hold of the ankles. As you engage through the biceps, the shoulder blades squeeze to push the heart forward. The feet open like a book. Big inhale here. And on an exhale, draw the heart towards the feet. So keeping the spine long, resist the temptation to round forward. Nice and long here. And if you'd like, you can press your elbows into your knees. You can rock side to side or flutter the knees if you wish. Or three. Two. Last one, big inhale. slowly start to come on up. Bring the left knee in and slide the right foot underneath. And bring that left foot over top. So I'm still doing my yoga teacher practice of doing the opposite side that I say I'm doing, because in a class I would mirror you. But I think with the video, it's not quite exactly the same. So just listen to my words, not what you're seeing. And so what I just said was that the left leg is over top of the right. Using the right hand to wrap around the left knee, hug it into the chest, and just rock a little bit forward and back. This is another one of those moves, these yoga moves, that I will typically do more in my restorative class than in my flow class. But since the theme today was self-care and self-massage, I like to think of this as a way to massage into this hip area, the sciatic area, the piriformis area, the glute, the butt. And this rocking sensation can just help with that massaging sensation. As long as you're not hunched down, make sure you're sitting up nice and tall. Two more deep breaths. Last one, big inhale. And exhale. And go ahead and switch to the other side. So this time, left foot comes underneath, right foot comes up and over. Make sure your both sits bones are on the ground, so you're not kind of teeter-tottering over to the side, but make enough space for that right sits bone to come all the way to the ground. You might notice one side is a little bit tighter than the other. You can spend a little bit more time on that in your personal practice. And when you're ready, left arm wraps around right knee. There's a need to readjust. And hug it into the chest as you sit up nice and tall. And then just find that little bit of rocking. That little bit of breathing. Send the breath right into the area of your body where you feel the stretch. Keep sitting up tall. Three more deep breaths. Two. Sigh it out with me. Big inhale. And exhale. If you're just jumping on, feel free to jump in. We're kind of towards the end here. We're going to be getting into our final relaxation, so it's a perfect place to join in if you're interested in the meditation portion. Just got a couple of more movements that we'll take before we get into our final relaxation. So slowly find your way all the way down onto the back, hug the knees into the chest, you can rock side to side. Our theme today was self-care and self-love, so again, this is a way to give yourself a little bit of self-massage. You can circle with the knees in one direction. And circle with the knees in the other direction. I like to take the knees out and around. And reverse. Hands behind the hamstrings. Just gonna rock and roll. This is another way to massage along the spine. Last one. And when you're ready, come on down. Start to find your way for your final shavasana. So if you have a blanket to place on your body, I would recommend doing that. You can also use a blanket, just a very thin blanket for under the head, but not a big pillow. However, if you do have any back pain, you're going to want to put something under your knees, whether it's a pillow, or I don't know if you can see my couch here, but you can actually lay with the knees up on a couch, and that allows the lower back to relax. But we wouldn't use a pillow under the head, because that strains the neck. The one exception for that rule is if I'll demo this before I get settled down. You guys keep getting settled in. But if when you're laying on your back, and this is a great tip for yoga teachers, if one of your clients really has their chin up when they're laying flat on their back because the back of the neck is so tight, that's where bringing in a pillow or even as much as a block can be really helpful, because we want the spine to be long to keep that flow of energy and not crunched in the back of the neck. And that pretty much goes across the board for the entire yoga practice. We want to keep the back of the neck in line with the spine. Of course, it has a nice natural curve, but nothing crunched. Okay, that being said, find your way into your final Shavasana. Settle in here. So we've been working on self-care and self-massage today. We're going to carry that forward into our meditation. So get any last wiggles and jiggles out of the way and find yourself resting comfortably here. Allowing your awareness itself to be a form of self-care or self-massage. One of the things we talked about in the bodywork sessions that we were training last night is that when someone gives you a massage, it is not actually their hands that are healing you. But when their hands press on a part of your body and your awareness moves to that part of the body, it is your awareness that heals from within. So the gift of massage is the gift of remembering parts of your body that maybe your brain has tuned out because of discomfort, pain, tension, trauma. Think about that. When a massage therapist works on your body, it is not their hands that heal. It is your awareness of the knots, the trigger points, the tightness. It is your awareness that brings healing to your own body. So just notice where your awareness is right now. And start to draw all of your awareness into your heart. Allow your beating heart to be the only thing that you are aware of in this moment. Feel a sensation of having a healed heart. And allowing that awareness to drop down to the tailbone. The root. The area where you connect with the earth. With other beings through sexuality or birth. Healing to those connections. Allow your awareness to move into both hips and through the upper legs, the lower legs. The ankles, the feet. And as we move through our full body relaxation, remember that your awareness is bringing healing to every part of your body that you become aware of. This is a self healing practice as you bring your awareness to relax and heal through the toes and the feet, the ankles, the shins and the calves. Bring your awareness, your own healing energy to the knees. Feel that healing in your knee area. Your awareness travels, relaxation, energy, healing flows through the inner and outer thighs, the quadriceps, hamstrings, the hip flexors or groin area, the outer hips and into the glutes or buttocks muscles. Bring your awareness, your relaxation, your healing energy into the hips, the hip joints, the pelvic floor. The lower belly or womb space. And through all of the internal organs, become aware of and call awareness and healing to your digestive system. Your assimilation system. Your elimination system. Your reproductive system. Feeling that healing energy with your awareness as you relax up through the diaphragm, the lungs and the ribs, the intercostal muscles between the ribs. Soften the heart. Relax into the chest or pectoral muscles, into the armpits and down the side bodies to the lower back. Soften and relax, widen through the lower back. Move your awareness left to right as if you're combing through, bringing healing to any areas of tension through the lower back and up into the middle back. And the upper back, allow your awareness to travel up and down the spinal area, combing through the muscle fibers, bringing awareness to any areas of tension or pain, and just breathe into those areas. Allow your awareness to bring healing. As you continue to relax and heal through the back body, allow the shoulder blades to melt down towards the earth. Relax across the tops of the shoulders and into the biceps and triceps, the elbows, the forearms, the wrists. Relax the backs and the palms of the hands and into the tips of all 10 fingers. Can you feel that healing energy pulsing at the fingertips and the hands? hands, those hand chakras. And slowly allow your awareness to travel back down through the fingers, bringing healing through the hands, the wrists, the lower arms, the elbows, the upper arms, the shoulders. Relax down the collarbones and up the front of the neck, around the sides of the neck and up the back of the neck. Relax all the way up the back of the neck to the crown of the head. Relax the skull and the scalp. Even relax the hair. Feeling that wave of healing energy through the neck and the head and into the forehead, across the temples, the sides of the head, the ears, and into the lower jaw. Bringing relaxation and deep healing to the jaw, the lips, the tongue, even the teeth and the roof of the mouth. From the roof of the mouth, through the sinuses, to the nose and cheeks. Relax across the nose and cheeks. And into the eye area. Relax the eyebrows, the eyelids, the circular muscles that line the eye socket. Even the eyeballs relax and sink deep. There's a gentle inwards and upwards rotation of the eyes, nothing forced, totally natural as your awareness comes to the center of the brain at the tippy top of the spinal column. Relax the brain as a muscle, feel it soften. Feel it be healed. As your body becomes more strong and flexible through the power of yoga, so too can your mind become more strong and flexible through the power of yoga. Both strength and flexibility assist and support in these self-healing practices, these self-healing journeys. And breathing new life into your body, your mind, and your intention by deepening the breath. Wiggle the fingers and the toes, the wrists and the ankles. You can move the head from side to side and reach the arms up overhead. Take a nice full body stretch on the inhale. Exhale, let it all go. Let's do that again. Inhale, stretch, fingertips to toes. Don't forget the toes. Big inhale. And exhale, relax. Bend one knee at a time. Bring your feet to the mat below you. Roll through either side, through the fetal position. Feeling comforted and held here. Held and healed. And when you're ready, very gently press yourself up to a comfortable seat. Bringing your hands to press together at heart center, remembering your intention, remembering that you are your own greatest healer, that you have everything you need. And we'll seal our practice with two cleansing breaths and one om in through the nose and out through the mouth. This time sigh. This time om. pressing the thumbs into the heart, lips, and forehead, reminding us to keep care of ourselves and what we carry in our hearts, what we speak in our words, and what we think in our minds and our thoughts. As we bow to each other, it is to all beings. The healer within me honors and supports the healer within each of you. Namaste. Thank you guys so much for joining me today. If you stuck with me through the class, please leave a comment and let me know. It's the only way I'll know who it was that was with me through the entire class. Thank you guys so much for your continued support. You know, these small donations that come through on Venmo and PayPal each time you take this class, whether it's live or on a repeat, it is sustaining me right now. It is just bringing me so much joy and appreciation and ability to continue living my life and continue being of service. So thank you for any donations that you're able to make. Also, thank you for shout outs, blessings, prayers, sharing this video on Facebook Live, and especially for those of you that are able to go on YouTube and subscribe to my YouTube channel. I left the link in the comments here. I'm hoping to get to 1,000 subscribers so I can change the name of my URL from some random number to like Kim Doyle. And if you go on there, there's a few interviews that I posted, so those are what are going to come up first, and then you'll see the whole library of all the yoga classes that I have recorded in the past, I guess it's been a month now since we've been in quarantine. I'm also available for one-on-one yoga sessions. I have one with a student of mine tomorrow that I'm very excited about. Usually these sessions run an hour and a half to 2 hours, so we have enough time to drop in and chat and catch up and move through the whole yoga practice. And if there's specific things you want to work on physically in terms of poses, we can do that. But also if there's specific things that you want to work on spiritually, I can weave those teachings into the class so that you really get them on a cellular level. I just love and appreciate you guys so much. And please reach out to me if you have any questions or if you'd like to connect for, you know, even just spiritual support and one-on-one coaching. That's something that I've been offering for a long time. I don't talk about it a lot, but I'm here for you. You know, we can do this. We can support each other. I'm not here to help you, but I am here to support you in helping yourself. So thank you so much. I'll see you guys for this same style class on Wednesday at 9:30 Mountain Time. It's Monday, Wednesday, Friday. And Tuesday, Thursday, 3 p.m. Mountain Time, we'll do a restorative class. Thank you guys so much. See you soon.